news is that we're only about half done with winter. That's what this concert means. So, no, actually, this everything that happens after this, in the band world anyway, is off spring. So our next thing is New York and contests and things like that. So that, you know, March Madness, all that business. So looking forward to it, man. It's been a long one, hasn't it? Anyway. I'd like to welcome you all. We've got a great deal of music to play for you today, and we have been blessed, I think, with a really, really good student teacher to help out in band. And, you know, when you get college students that are coming into somebody else's program, it's so incredibly hard because they're so used to doing, you know, things the way I do things, and, you know, whoever you get is always going to be a little bit different, so it takes a long time for the kids to sort of adjust, and it's really good for them, actually. So. We're going to meet Mr. Lucian here. Mr. Lucian is a Lakeville person, and he's a Concordia senior, and he'll be graduating in the spring here and looking for a job. So if anybody knows of any band directing jobs, but he's been really, really good, and he'll have a chance to conduct a few of the tunes tonight. So I'd like to welcome to the stage now Mr. Ryan Lucian.
Just really does it the right way. So we'll keep the program moving for you with this next piece called Legend of the Alhambra by Mark Williams.
Thank you.
NFL Parks and the Patriots, and it's really kind of a cool thing because what he does is he takes more than a couple, it's probably 5, 6, 7 different American type tunes, but he just takes little snippets of it and then creates his own melody from that. So you hear little bits and pieces of these American tunes that you'll recognize, but they don't finish at all. They just kind of finish in their own way. So this is March of the Patriots.
Thank you.
So while we've all been plowing out and dealing with snow, these seventh graders have been learning 16th notes. And that's kind of an exciting thing because once they get to 16th notes, then they unlock just a whole bunch of new music that they're able to play. So you're going to hear it. There's going to be four notes and one beat. So it's yet, 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 they go fast and they're really, really fun. This is Whirlwinds.
Thank you.
have, like, everything you listen to, like, in your car, is in 4/4 time. Not everything. A lot of things are written in 4/4 time. That means you have 4 beats per measure. This, not only is it not always 4 beats per measure, but it's switching constantly. It starts out with 4/4, then 3/4, and so it's really just presented the challenge to, first of all, count, right, and know where we are, and then since this idea is happening throughout the whole thing, it really ends up being it's a different feel, right? It's something that we're not used to, and it really makes for a fun piece. So this is Gradients by Brian Bonnage.
Thank you.
The next tune that we're going to play for you, Destined to Fly, has a very, very specific meaning, and I'm not even going to try to paraphrase it. I have exactly what the composer says right here. In speaking with, this is the composer speaking, in speaking with Freeport Intermediate School band director Randy Laren, I was deeply moved with the emotion and genuine fondness with which he spoke of his student Juan Bora, who tragically passed away. As we discussed plans for a tribute piece, Mr. Laren shared with me his accomplishments in school and his many aspirations for the future. I immediately began formulating a title and eventually arrived at Destined to Fly, inspired by this young man's courage to explore the unknown and always dream big. Subsequently, in a most heartbreaking turn of events, the piece took a deeper meaning when Mr. Laren himself met his untimely end in July 2017. Lovingly dedicated to the families of Juan Bora, Randy Laren, and the Freeport, Texas Intermediate School Band, this composition comes with profound condolences and a heavy heart. And so, there's not really a way to talk about this meeting and do it justice. But what he also says is that music often expresses feelings and arouses emotions that words just simply cannot. You know, I could not. There's not much more I can say here, but I think it's really going to come out in this music.
Thank you.
So much of the music for movies written now are, it's just a little less melodic than back in the 80s and stuff with the Star Wars and stuff. The Avengers is a perfect example. All the Marvel, you know, you think back to the Marvel themes and stuff, it's kind of hard to hum them back, where literally everybody could probably hum back the theme to Superman or E.T. or any of those great John Williams scores from the 80s. But the energy's still there. You can see that they do that on purpose. They don't want the music to distract from the film by being too melodic and drawing too much attention to itself. It's just the whole philosophy and aesthetic has kind of changed over the years. So Avengers is perfectly like that. It's got the same exact feel, it just doesn't have the memorable melody. So this is a theme from the Avengers.
Thank you.
Sucks you in. It's really, really good when you watch it. And we're going to see it live, and it's going to be really good. It's the number one show on Broadway right now. The guy we'll see is the Tony Award winning, the best guy that we'll see. And really looking forward to that. But it's basically just a whole bunch of tunes that we know. And now that they moved it to the Broadway stage from the movie, they added a whole bunch of new music now. So instead of, like, I think 129 different songs in the movie, now there's like 236, and it's like Lady Gaga and all these newer artists, you know, that have emerged in the last, 10 years or so. So that's Moulin Rouge. We're very excited about that. The next piece is called the Copland Tribute, and it features the music of Aaron Copland. Now, Aaron Copland was really the guy to invent American music. So anything that you hear, from Westerns, think of any cowboy music, think of any, Americana-type songs, you'll hear it. He wrote. If he hadn't done that, I think the whole history of our film music, too, would be quite a bit different. But anyway, you'll hear probably pieces from four or five different Appalachian Spring, Rodeo, all of these different tunes that he's written in a very American style. So also, if anybody's really interested in getting into classical music, this is a great place to start because it's really, really accessible. It's very melodic and it's really intense. But this is Aaron Copland's A Copland Tribute by Claire Grundy.
Thank you.
too. It's just really exposed and awesome job, guys. Our next piece is from the musical Wicked, which we'll also be seeing in New York, and it's called Popular, and you may recognize it. Features Lily Williams back there on the alto sax. Lily, we should have had you stand up and play the solo. You want to do that? No, we've never practiced it like this, but I thought, you know, we made Sam stand up during that last one, during the last concert. I don't know, we're going to put her on the spot. She's so good that she's just going to stand up and play that solo. And then sit down. It's not just all about you. This will feature Lily Williams unexpectedly.
Things that maybe should be called solos or solis, but really aren't, even though they function as that. So it's really been, it's been a challenge to work on that and how we can play independently and still keep time together and make this piece into the dance feel that it is. So here is Sundance by Frank Tegal.
We have one more, but I had to make one more appearance, even though I'm not ready. Just want to thank you guys for being an awesome audience. I just love, you know, when I go to other high school band concerts and the crowd is so loud and, you know, there's just people talking and this is really, really good. You guys are amazing. So thanks for being great. Hey, our next stop is going to be New York and then we'll be back here in May for our spring concert. Hopefully it'll be a little warmer, a little less snow by then, but thanks for coming.